pace on to the northern side. But then again, no matter where they are, the initial circle will still dictate the pace of the game here.
True enough, and majority of the case has always been the very traditional circles around, you know, the cross section of Monte Nevo, and sometimes
we're already on a game number two, so I believe
which hancur ganteng dulu kan kali. Kayak jadi better bikin semua ganteng kali ya.
Taken down nodes on how to improve and maybe how to flank and do an effective rotation compared to the rest of the teams here.
Kayaknya
just reaping, you know, all the hard work that they've done, you know, for at least day number one.
Kayaknya ini
and it's a, you know,
game ya, PUBG ya. Perlu ada teleportasi.
It's gonna be a wild
biar bisa teleport gitu ke dalam zona.
Get out with the engines running because this is where things get really rough for the teams that are coming from the far west end, as well as the X that's hoping to penetrate the area where Panda is currently at over the north side.
Levi's actually just got knocked down.
Aduh.
No confirmation just yet.
Ora
is already been eliminated, but 001, aka Sitar,
susah.
Is also bleeding out there in the open, and they're going up against Aura Esports. Okay, so this is a tough competition
susah,
right here. We've
susah,
got Sky
susah.
Popping up some smokes here. Again, we've seen the circle a while ago, and it's gonna be a busy west side. We can still see a lot of teams, right, will be coming from that direction. So I guess there will be a lot of potential
crashes,
but Horror Esports leaving the scene right now is the okay. So two more members left for the side of Bigotron Red Alias, and they are receiving some massive hits coming from Leon over here. So they're not letting Horror Esports escape that quickly. So I guess they're gonna chase them down.
Yeah, they should be pretty much well-oiled to take this spot
if they really want to. Now opening a little bit of space, cutting through the south side as well.
Oh my god.
It's just going to be driving towards the direction of Nine Noi, so he's got to be ready to take on BTR. Meanwhile, pickoffs happening over the bottom end of the field. It will be Geekman that will have Mika taken out. Nate's also joining into the party as well. And KT trades back. And oh boy, the names are just running while on the field. The rest of Dota for the moment. Links knows that there's still two more members right down onto the ridges. Trev's now popping a grenade, hoping to actually find one, but not really getting anything at all. This is definitely going to be a tough predicament for the side of Toda as they are being scattered into two different
positions.
Coming in with a backpack dropped in by the side of Shreps. So down to two members left. Vampire Esports storms the gate, trying to look for their targets. And it seems like Toda, they just want to defend one singular room. And this is going to be a tight one for them to hold out.
And Todak is not even moving a muscle here. They're letting Vampire Esports actually, you know, get inside.
This
is waiting for them to take the bait. Now we've got Shreps holding on that to that nade to kind of disorient them with what's happening just outside. But an effective shot coming from Clay Rider, but Shreps already to push forward and ready to take the win. Vampire Esports with 6 elimination points wins the fight up against Todak. Was that Todak or Team CP?
It was Todak. Oh my. Like, that was a heavy casualty fight. Like, despite them actually winning the trade, they were left with only one member. The flank coming from Leon.
They do need to hurry up in terms of picking up their teammate, picking up their fallen comrades, because BTR also aggressively throwing in nades to flush them out once again from inside of this compound.
My, I wasn't expecting Tony K to actually clutch that moment. You saw what really happened. They were all arriving, funneled into the same direction on the outside, where Geekfam was not even inside the compound. And by playing on the outskirts, every VPB members was just trying to figure out where exactly to go. The moment they stepped out, and once they were figured out, they were all going into the same line of sight against the side of Geekfam. And speaking of on the outskirts, look at BTR, they now find themselves within range of grenades being tossed in from the side of NKT. Advancing forward with Joker coming in from the back as well. It's only going to be Hans. Hans Chul. So, yeah, the names are getting a little bit more confusing coming from the side of BTR. So, yeah, It is what it is. BTR only has one member left standing in the way. So NKT, the bigger fish to fry is actually Vampire Esports, which they have not spotted out just yet.
Yeah, I feel for Hans though. I mean, he's sandworms. And who will be the biggest sandworm to take him out?
What?
I mean, he's sandwiched in between. Tough way to go, not gonna lie here. Hands now, about to go out. Ooh, huge damage coming from that nade from Vampire. And
oi, kalian, jangan gitulah. Anak sekecil itu mau lawan 7 orang.
He's still trying his level best. Meanwhile, Tony K is basically confident to push onto the outskirts, trying to pressurize with some grenades once again in exchange. But Vampire Esports, they don't really have that much time. The circle's about to shift. In this top 5 battle, it has been pretty much a tight gridlock between NKT as well as VP. Not that they're even fighting each other, they're just really hoping to take that one corner, wasting a lot of resources at the same time as well. So I don't really think that is all too well worth it, but they try as they may, as they send more of these players up to eventually get Han. He does get the DBS out there, and he will suppress one member of Tony Kane.
Aduh,
on the ground, and that will eventually be picked up.
BTR
is already out, but here comes the rest of NKT. The other Thai team that has been waiting in the wings will try to gatekeep. You learn a whole lot more by some of all these mistakes committed along the way. So it's good to actually make mistakes sometimes, but not all the time, you know? So that's where teams are going to be looking at the fine balance as we finally get ourselves into action, as we already have shots being fired across the field. And it will be casualties across the board for the side of 7-9 as they challenge T2K.
Aromacy, Viv got on then with that nade, did not connect at all, but I guess that compromises this position. Again, in order to pull off a great, you know, like mid to long range.
Unfortunately, of course, we may have actually missed certain action as we are now down to only 13 teams left. We'll keep you guys up to speed on what exactly went on, but here comes BTR. They're holding on to Rozok as we are going to be having them hold out against a certain up-approaching team, but I believe that things are looking to be pretty safe for the side of BTR for now.
Hey, so it only goes to show
that has won in Miramar. Meanwhile, RRQ Ryu and a hot team coming in from Indonesia had some really good battles inside of Miramar. Find themselves in the thick of things as they are currently occupying some of the areas on the outskirts of school, as well as the opening fields of Yasnaya as well. So it's already 5 total eliminations, or should I add it to 6 for BTR? What a good start it has been for the Indonesian side, as BTR, they were just holding on Rose up, and teams are just passing through, and they get caught.
Man, also for the side of Tribe Aromacy, they're no longer part of the game, but they did exit the game with 2 elimination points. Now, you brought up, you know, having to do some mistakes. How they're going to be engaging in fights, you know, from inside a battlefield.
Indeed, and speaking of that, we have also seen a lot of all these players just growing every step of the way throughout the course of
members as well. So that is one heck of a job right there coming from T2K, which brings us down to just 10 teams remaining. And now here comes Todak, here comes a 9 with that nade attack, challenging up the boys of Bigatron Red Alias. But in the meantime, he needs to pick up his comrades right here. He needs to keep BTR at bay. He may be buying some time for them to reset.
They managed to do so very efficiently as well. Famous in one of the members' hands could prove to be quite lethal later on in the course of the match, but what a great choke point that TTK has set up to be able to reap all these rewards, and TTK has got their best performance so far. 9 elimination points to kick off their run here inside of Wrangle. Meanwhile, Cleon has got that nade. Don't overcook it, my friend, but that is going to be tossed nicely over on the bottom, close enough, but not gonna be able to knock them down just quite yet. BTR now alarmed with their presence of danger. Todak is just gonna be around, but they won't be making any firm decisions to actually go in for the rush just yet. So everyone's just being chilling for now while they're just hoping to see how the next shift of the circle is going to be out. But team,
those elimination points is just putting themselves out there. Very courageous, right? And they have the opportunity, of course, to assume points coming from the side of Aegon IA. They are applying a lot of pressure there and just really unleashing havoc, so to speak. But unfortunately, Kwan goes down, so it's all up to Gosu to defend a team Flash. But with that much firepower in front of him, let's just wait and see if he can manage to survive together with his teammate.
Yeah, look at the circle as well. It really depends on how the hardships happens, but Team Flash, they bow out. That was a little bit overwhelming in terms of numbers, but what a valiant effort it was with only those two members. As we saw, they did manage to put in quite the challenge. Now, depending on the circle shift, it could either favor the side of T2K or maybe the ones over on the open field. Shots now being fired from the side of BTR, looking for the target. We'll be able to knock one down from the side of RRQ. Now, I'm not too sure if they will turn back to actually pick up Fnatic, but they should do so. But the bullets are just too immense for them to even respond. So BTR will be inching closer into a 10-pointer, now settling for 9.
Hey, I'm seeing one of them using a micro Uzi once again, ladies and gents. Could this be coming back on trend? That is still the big question. I am a big micro Uzi user, so I would love to have them back. But of course, DBS remains to be the meta here, as well as S12K. I mean, it's a one quick way to put down or to shut down an opponent, or like just make them go down to their knees. So going to be a bloodbath if the teams decide to actually engage with one another.
See how that one will turn out, but Lynx, his vehicle is starting to smoke up, so these sort of drive-bys to bait and switch isn't exactly doing much favor for themselves as well. May as well just take that compound and just settle it without exposing too much. So they've been noisy neighbors with Bigatron Red Aliens for the longest of time. That won't be changing anytime soon until this circle shrinks all the way in. And by then, BTR is definitely looking for it for that close proximity fight to charge.
It's from Todak and BTR, but can they be successful? We'll just have to wait it out.
I think, like, regardless of the case, hitting in this top 5, BTR definitely has big advantages up ahead, and this IA has got a massive run throughout this course of the battle. They've got themselves, what, 10 elimination points already? Meanwhile, T2K is struggling to squeeze by because the circle shifts so far off. They're forced towards the hills, and they have to deploy all these smokes to keep themselves alive. Meanwhile, Todak now ambushes the rest of BTR over the backside as well. Fights are happening all over the map, and BTR, they will send it all the way through, but it is going to be Todak that will get those elimination points as they will eliminate the aliens off the map.
He's from Panda.
Okay, right. we'll get the names right next time around, but wow. I took a look at the circle, and this is not
good. And Trang just made sure that they're still coming back from there. I mean, and he continues on to fight, you know, up against that one player. He's obviously swimming from in the waters right there. But yeah, I mean, is he keeping like two sides here, defending two sides? I'm not sure, but yeah, I mean, obviously, Team Secret pretty aggressive, to be honest, in terms of the security.
Yeah, it's just gonna be a slightly tougher than usual, but you can see that the bridge is pretty much compromised by the members of Team Pandem. Secret having a very difficult time to move off. There's not going to be boats that's going to be functional for them to cross over onto the local sector. Jabranki getting shot through the smokes as he will try his level best. It was all smokes and maybe some mirrors as well. Levi is now crashing through. Now beautiful teamwork to be able to deny Vampire Esports. They will take back what is theirs, that number one spot on the table.
The spoils of the... Did I think that right? Okay, we're just gonna check it out later. But yeah, I mean,
right,
yeah. The back of the future. Now they're looking at Bigatron, a red alien, and okay, they're having an exchange. I guess with who? Team Secret? Oh yeah, okay, so Team Secret got eliminated, I guess, with two elimination points. What was it, Team Secret? Yes. No, that's Todak! That's Todak Esports. Okay.
Here goes my prediction yet again, but it does not really matter too much because Leo here is hoping to take revenge for my predictions as well, Leo Esports. Having Haidami finally making measures for himself. And DO1 is a, well, that, what DO1, it is Satar 001. So, Haidami now looking around as he could not really spot much through the smoke. Satar dancing around, and that is going to be a final tap with the DBS. Quick, clean. That's four pointers on the block.
Amount of teams that will be coming from the northern side, and soon enough, you know, all the prime location here from inside the circle will be occupied, so that will be the start of the engagement that definitely happening here in Minor. But as for Tribe Aramis, you just look at the distance that they will have to travel just to get inside the safe zone.
Yeah, it's a very, very long drive for them to actually make it to that point. But I believe that there should be some openings where they could actually cut through as well. Meanwhile, have they settled the scores just yet for the side of T2K? At this moment, not exactly in the best picture when it comes down to the position. And wow, hard shift, look at that. All the teams who are around the area was hoping it to be around Puerto Paraiso or Los Leones. It goes over onto the outskirts of Chumacera instead.
Yeah, and it's a good thing that there's a lot of elevation, I mean, in this particular area, but we will see a lot of teams exit the game. That is for sure, considering where the circle actually landed. But you know what? The fight continues on between Team Flash and DRS left with just two members right here. And Whoa. Team Flash getting picked off. That's what Bowser's already on the ground. So it's just the Batman.
Everybody else is just so much more healthy in comparison. Still 15 teams remain, but we'll see the numbers slowly dwindle down with the Boing Donkey already approaching a battle against the side of FaZe Clan. Ventura signs one, catching out Yuhai Boyas. That will be one off from the Malaysian squad. Meanwhile, Boing Donkey goes into the thick of things. Mineral quickly goes in for the tap, but he's stepping onto the fires and flames. And it's Roar from the back that stashes it away.
Man, long distance elimination.
Perfectly for the end game. Roy is in a really good position. This is also one of the first few times that we actually see Roy moving into a top 8. So massive improvement coming from the Vietnamese squad, which has been near the bottom of the barrel for most part of the tournament. So perhaps this is going to be their lifeline performance to be put onto the table for them to survive the semifinals. Because honestly, we're already moving into day two. There's not going to be too many games heading to the next couple of days if they don't start stacking up points.
You know what? I just have to give kudos to Lynx of Todak. I mean, he has been saying in the same spot, you know, for a good few minutes, right? And he's not getting spotted, which is, of course, what he needs to do. I mean, focus on longevity here and get those personal points. Now, in the meantime, of the red aliens, but he is a little slow in the trigger there. That's why he finds himself on the ground as well.
Wow, with one tick of HP bar left, Lapar still managed to go in for the trade and still managing to keep the rest of the team afloat. But here comes the rest of NKT. I think this is going to be that perfect opportunity to strike as well. He can only revive one, so he needs to make this one count. And the more time being bought, that's going to be the whole squad back up. The whole squad being three members, as a matter of fact. But look at that, 52 Esports, NKT surrounding BTR. Where exactly could they go? I don't think that this is a good position at all. They need to find somewhere else that's safer from here.
Yeah, they're like sitting ducks right here. I mean, all they need to do is just really throw in a lot of nades and BTR could be wiped out entirely. And permanently, I guess. And there you go, BTR with two elimination points.